Come on, man.
I'll tell you what love is. Love, sharing, caring, commitment.
Preach on, Tommy.
Love is two souls joined together as one.
School your boys.
Love is flowers for no reason. Love is telling her all the things she wants to hear. Until you get the draw!
Yeah, Tommy. Boy, I'ma tell you, you scared me for a minute, man.
What's good, y'all? It's your boy, Nick Bag, a.k.a. Biffy Lay Pew, a.k.a. No Ceilings, a.k.a. Love Feels. Yeah, man, and this is going to be like the, this is going to be like a segment to, As the Spliff Burns. I'm going to call this one Percy. I'm going to be by myself. I'm going to try to do this every Thursday. And I'm going to just, you know, talk my shit. I'm going to talk on these topics by myself. Personal ones, or not personal ones, just more so like questions that people ask me throughout the day that I feel like, you know, are worthy enough to, you know, have conversation or to open up the mind and to, you know, have y'all think and shit like that. I had got a question from one of the female listeners, and I call this Percy, so if I take a pause and you don't hear me talk, it's because I'm smoking. So yeah, so I got a question from one of the female listeners, and she asked me, what is my take on love? And I thought that was a good ass question, because we all have different views or different opinions on love, right? But I feel like nowadays in this generation or in this era, we don't see love as much as we used to or as often as we did. Yeah, you got social media and shit, and a nigga might put you up on a Wednesday, and you might post his picture on a Monday, but is that genuine love? Is you posting a picture of a nigga on your social media, does that count as love? Is that what love has been denounced to nowadays? Just a picture on social media, and boom, we're happy, we're satisfied? Me personally, I can't speak for everyone in general. I can only speak for myself and what I've been through. So what I've been through personally, I've never been in a serious relationship but one my entire life. I'm 26 years old, so I've only been in one serious relationship. I mean, high school relationships don't really count because it's high school. You know what I'm saying? You're still learning yourself as an actual person. And, I would say most of the majority of the time, like when we're growing up and, certain shit like that, love isn't necessarily spoken about. Like, you're almost, all right, so as a man, right, we're taught, or not taught, but like more so society teaches us not to be in tune with our emotions. You know what I mean? It's not cool to be a man and be in tune with your emotions, says society. You know what I'm saying? You're supposed to be the tough guy. You're supposed to be, you know what I mean? Oh, fuck you and fuck that, da, 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 da. I don't have any feelings. Yeah, for certain, I was definitely like that. You know what I'm saying? You jumping into a relationship with a girl or whatever, whatever, in high school. And if stuff goes sour, you always be like, man, fuck it. I'm going to get some new pussy. Da, 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 da. I'm going to get some bitches. Da, 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 blah, 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 blah. And there's niggas like that that still has this mindset to this day. And I definitely did have that mindset as well. And to me, I thought, like, you know, shit, I'm the man. Like, you know what I mean? Like, you know what I mean? You lose one girl, at least you got two of them. You got three of them, nigga, you bounce back. I thought that made me the man. But no, you know, little did I know, you're still a boy if you still have that mindset. You know what I mean? And what's really fucked up about it also is, like, a lot of times in our culture, like, you know, we never see love up close. Like, you know what I mean? Well, once again, I can only speak for myself. I can't speak for everybody. So I come from where I'm just raised by a female, by a woman, my mother. You know what I mean? My mother raised me. That was who raised me. So there was never an actual, you know, a male in the picture other than, you know, my two brothers. But even on top of that, what I'm getting at is there wasn't a father figure in the household that showed me what love was. You know what I mean? Me saying that, what I mean by that is, like, there wasn't anybody who was around that was loving my mother. So I've never seen love up close. I've never seen anybody like, damn, you see how daddy loves mommy? That's how I want to love my girl. Or, you know what I mean? That's how I want to love my wife. Da, 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 da. You know what I mean? I've never seen that. You know what I mean? I got two older brothers, and, you know what I mean? And, of course, at the time, niggas is just living the life. So, you know, they got bitches coming in and out. Da, 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 da. That's what I thought was right at the time. Like, you know what I mean? Like, you're supposed to have bitches coming in and out. Like, you're a fool if you don't have bitches. You're a fool if you settle down with one woman. I really thought that. I really had that mindset for a long time. And, you know, after doing some soul searching, you finally realize, like, there ain't shit out here. You could have multiple females and still feel empty. Like, you know, you could have multiple women and still just not, it still doesn't amount to just that one. Like, you know what I mean? You can find, you know what I mean, that one girl who does 1,000 things that these 1,000 women can do also. But it's just, like, I don't know. That's, but I just feel like, you know what I mean, because we don't have any guidance or any visual to it, that some of us do get lost. And now there's people who definitely do come from the mother and father household, and they see how it's supposed to be, and you know what I mean, and they know this is love and what love isn't, and you know what I mean, and they don't tolerate that bullshit. And then there's people who do come from a great household, and they still be on the bullshit, and they still have a crazy mindset, and you know what I mean. But I mean, honestly, it is what it is. Love is just, it's basically, I don't know. Like, I can't even, it's so hard to explain because everybody has their own opinion to it. So, to me, love is supposed to be, like, you know, submission. Like, if I can submit to you, if I can say, you know what, it's all right. Like, you know what, here, take this, here, da-da-da-da-da. Like, you know what I mean? Once you're able to forget about yourself, once you lose that ego, once it becomes no longer yourself and you're able to worry about somebody else, I think that's what love is. I think that's when you honestly get the true exact feeling, because you don't wish harm on that person. You don't want anything bad to happen to them. You don't want them to leave you or anything like that. You know what I'm saying? So you'll get the same, you know, you just, it's like a feeling as well. Like, you know, it's kind of like a comfort feeling. Like, you know what I mean? I don't know. It's just hard to explain. But like I said, though, society and everything else doesn't allow us to see love and to portray love. And you know what I mean? It doesn't show any of that. And it's fucked up because, you know, it's even in the music too. Even in the music, in the 90s, like back in the day, like niggas would sing and you wanted to fall in love. Like them songs you heard, like from the 70s, the 80s, the 90s, like you wanted to fall in love. Like nowadays, the songs now, it's just cool to be a savage. Like even bitches is using niggas now. Like it's crazy. Like, I don't know, man. It's ridiculous. Like, it's ridiculous. Like now it's just cool to be a savage. It's cool to like, you know what I mean, forget about feelings and just use everybody just for, like, you know what I mean, for personal gain. And that's crazy to me. Like, you know what I mean, the only thing that's gonna, that heals anything, the only thing that, you know, that we actually are built for is honestly is love. Like, that's it. Nothing else, nothing more. Not to sound corny, not to sound cliche, but that's it. Like, there's nothing more, there's nothing else to it. Everything else is just, like, you know, this is just what we're conditioned to. But that's a whole nother topic. That's a whole nother segment. You know what I'm saying? But that's my take on it. You know what I mean? I don't really know. I just feel like love is a beautiful thing, man. And if you're in love, you should cherish it forever. Don't you ever let it go. If you're not in love, don't rush to be in love. Like, you know what I mean? That's corny as well. It's supposed to happen. You know what I mean? It just pops up. It's not something that you rush. You know what I mean? So you can't just be like, You can't put like a time limit on it. You can't put like a stamp on it, like, you know, and rush it. Like, you have to allow it to come. You know what I mean? You can't be like, you know, the next relationship I'm in, my next spouse, like, we're definitely gonna fall in love. And you can't do that. You can't already have put those expectations on yourself and the next person. But once again, that's a whole nother topic. That's a whole nother, you know, I'm rambling on and on. But yeah, that's just my take on it. On love. So but yeah, man, that's just my take on it. That's just my take on love. I just feel like, you know, love is the draft, and you want to get drafted and you want to stay with the franchise forever. You know, 20 years, you want to see your jersey hang up in the Raptors. You know what I'm saying? But I want to thank y'all for tuning in. You know, I'm going to leave y'all with something real good. Something y'all could vibe out to, show you what I was talking about that music back in the 90s. But I'm going to see y'all next Thursday, you know, and we're going to see y'all on Saturday, you heard? I am the insane Kevin Payne. Drank your wine as you chased my eye. I kissed your